talking about enamel. So first, teeth is composed of three mineralized tissues. Okay, that is enamel, dentin, and cementum. What is pulp? Pulp is loose connective tissue. Pulp is loose connective tissue. पल्प इज लूज कनेक्टिव टिश्यू. ये नीट एमडीएस में आया है आपको 2017 और 18 को एक बार आया है. ठीक है. नाउ एनामेल, एनामेल के बारे में बात करेंगे. एनामेल इज ए कैल्सिफाइड टिश्यू. ओके, एनामेल इज ए कैल्सिफाइड टिश्यू. इट कवर्स द एनाटोमिक क्राउन. ओके, इट कवर्स द एनाटोमिक क्राउन. ओके, व्हाट इज एनाटॉमिक क्राउन, इसके बारे में हम डिस्कस करेंगे अगले स्लाइड में. एंड प्रोवाइड शेप एंड कंटूर टू टूथ. ओके, इट इज एक्टोडर्मल इन ओरिजिन. हमने पढ़ा है एम्ब्रायोलॉजी में एक्टोडर्मल, मेसोडर्मल एंड एंडोडर्म. ओके, सो दिस इज एक्टोडर्मल इन ओरिजिन. दिस इज द हार्डेस्ट टिश्यू ऑफ बॉडी. ओके, एनामेल इज द हार्डेस्ट टिश्यू ऑफ बॉडी एंड फिजियोलॉजिकली unrepairable tissue. This is unrepairable. Neither does it contain any, nor it has any blood supply of its own. So enamel is avascular. Okay. So anatomical crown kya hota hai? The anatomical crown is all of the tooth that is covered with the enamel. So portion of the tooth that is covered with enamel is known as anatomic crown. Okay, a portion of the tooth that is covered with enamel is known as anatomic crown. Then what is clinical crown? Clinical crown kya hai? Clinical crown is that part of the tooth that you see when you look in the mouth. So clinical crown, when you look in the mouth, oral examination में जो हम दिखते हैं, हमको दिखाई देता है, that is clinical crown. Okay? So what is ectoderm? Ectoderm is one of the three germ layers. Germ layers क्या होता है अभी? Germ layer is a group of cells in an embryo that interact with each other as the embryo develops. So these are group of cells. Okay? In an embryo which interact, जो आपस में इंटरेक्ट होते हैं as the embryo develops and contribute to the formation of all organs and tissue. So germ layers contribute to the formation of all organs and tissues. Okay, fine. So physical properties, what are the physical properties? So normally it is yellowish to grayish white with bluish tinge on incisal edge. This is you have to remember for first year BDS. When you write your exam, you have to write this. Pehla line ye likhna hi hai, theek hai? So enamel is whiter in younger teeth and with aging it becomes darker. Theek hai? Maximum thickness, thickness of enamel, thickness of enamel. Okay? It is maximum over the cusp, 2.5 mm, this is an MCQ, and reduced thickness over cervical margin. Cervical margin mein iska thickness kam hota hai, less than 100 micrometer. Okay, so this is tensile strength, yaad karna hai aapko 46, compressive strength 76, specific gravity 2.8, this is an MCQ, NEET MDS dental pulse mein aapko milega, you will find in dental pulse, theek hai? Hardness 296 KHN stands for, KHN hai noob hardness number. Okay, then refractive index is 1.62. permeability semi permeable, this is also an MCQ. So yahan se kya kya yaad rakhna hai, ratta marna hai aapko. Just a minute, I'll tell you. Specific gravity yaad rakho, specific gravity, hardness, refractive index and permeability, semi-permeable. You have to remember this, semi-permeable. Okay, next. So chemical properties, inorganic is 96% and organic is 4%. This is to be remembered. First year, not even first year, NEET MDS. This is a question. जो आपके डेंटल पल्स में यू विल फाइंड इन डेंटल पल्स दिस क्वेश्चन इज देयर व्हाट इज द इनऑर्गेनिक कंपोनेंट ऑफ आपका एनामेल सो यू हैव टू राइट 96% ऑर्गेनिक कंपोनेंट इज 4% ओके सो इनऑर्गेनिक कंपोनेंट में क्या आता है हाइड्रोक्सी एपेटाइट इज द मेन कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट बाय वेट इट इज 95-96% By volume, it is 88-90%. So by weight, it is 95-96%. By volume, 88-90%. Okay. By weight and by volume, it is different. So what is the structure? What is the chemical formula of hydroxyapatite? This comes in your exam. Chemical formula of hydroxyapatite. So this is Ca10PO46OH2. Okay. Then this is hexagonal in structure with width 17 nanometer and thickness 25 nanometer. Ions present in enamel are magnesium, lead, and fluoride. Fluoride is present in enamel. Also in cementum. Cementum may be fluoride hota hai. Okay. So organic component kya hai? मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट यहाँ पे याद रखो प्रोटीन्स अमिलोजेनिन्स एंड नॉन अमिलोजेनिन्स तो प्रोटीन्स क्या आता है अमिलोजेनिन्स एंड नॉन अमिलोजेनिन्स ओके अमिलोजेनिन इज ए टायरोसिन रिच पेप्टाइड टायरोसिन एक प्रोटीन है इज ए प्रोटीन अमिलोजेनिन इज ए टायरोसिन रिच पेप्टाइड टाइटली बाउंड टू एपेटाइट क्रिस्टल Okay. So this is what is enamel protein. So enamel protein is remember not collagen. Okay, it is neither like collagen nor they are keratin. Enamel protein is neither collagen nor keratin. Okay, all other tissues dentin ho apka. Pulp ho, cementum ho, they contain collagen, but enamel is keratin-like. This is an MCQ in your dental pulse. Okay? So keratin-like. Okay? Enamel is keratin-like. Enamel is keratin-like. So amelogenins 90%, non-amelogenins 10%. Okay? Amelogenins are low molecular weight. And this non-amelogenins are high molecular weight. MCQ. This is MCQ. Rich in proteins such as proline, histidine, and glutamine. So this is also an MCQ. And this non-amelogenin are rich in gas. Okay, you remember gas. Okay, no gas. You remember like this non-amelogenin gas. Okay, glycine, aspartic acid, and serine. Okay, what are the non-amelogenin name kya hai? Enamelin and ameloblastin are the example of non-amelogenins. Okay, so amelogenins are used for gender determination. They can be used for gender determination. Okay, what is the function of amelogenin? It help in crystal growth. Jo crystal hota hai, hydroxyapatite crystal. So amelogenin helps in the growth of that crystal. If amelogenin not expressed properly, it leads to enamel hypoplasia. So amelogenin agar acche se express nahi hua, to kya hota hai? Enamel hypoplasia. Even misexpression of non-amelogenin also causes enamel hypoplasia. Okay? So mutation of amel gene. Ek amel gene hai, amel and ek hai enam gene. Okay? This is an MCQ. Okay, gene can lead to amelogenesis imperfecta. Mutation of amel gene and enam gene can lead to amelogenesis imperfecta. Fine. So, what is the constituent of water in enamel? By weight, it is 2%. by volume 5 to 10%. This is MCQ. Okay, water lies in between crystal, trapped in defects of crystalline structure. Okay, so we'll be talking about the structure of enamel. Okay, enamel mein kya hota hai? There are enamel rods. Okay, we will talk about enamel rods. Okay, so what are enamel rod? Enamel rod are the basic structural unit of enamel. So enamel rod are the structural unit of enamel. Okay, so structural unit, like cell is the structural unit of
excuse me
for bone. Okay, neuron for CNS. Okay, phir nephron for kidney. Okay, so similarly this enamel rods are the structural unit of enamel. Okay, so enamel rods are the structural unit of enamel. Rods are thin, running from DJ to surface in a tortuous manner. So how are the enamel rods? They run like this, tortuous manner. Okay, not straight, tortuous manner. Okay, from DJ matlab kya hai? Dentino enamel junction. Okay, dentino enamel junction. So dentino enamel junction se wo to the surface of enamel, it runs in a tortuous manner. Length of rods are more than the width. So length is more than the width. Okay, you have to remember this. Longer in cuspal region than cervical area. So enamel rods are long in cuspal region than cervical area. Okay, so these things have to be remembered. Nothing much to understand, but more to remember. Okay, so enamel rod in cross section is described as hexagonal or keyhole shaped. Okay, enamel rods are hexagonal or keyhole. Keyhole kaise hota hai? It's like this, right? So this is looking like a human being, but a keyhole. I think you understand what I am trying to draw. I'm very poor in drawing. Anyway, keyhole. So it looks like keyhole. Okay, or it is hexagonal in structure. Okay, head area of prism is formed by individual amyloblasts. So this is the head portion, this is the tail. Okay, I'll draw again. So this is the head and this is the tail. Okay, so head portion is formed by one amyloblast. Okay, and the tail portion is formed by three amyloblasts. Okay, tail area produce up to three neighboring amyloblasts. Three amyloblasts milke tail is formed. Okay, and the head is formed by one amyloblast. So this is also neat MDS MCQ. You can find it in your dental pulse. Okay, you please go through dental pulse immediately after you finish the class. You will find that you will be able to solve 90 to 95% of the questions. So diameter of the rod increases from DJ to surface in a ratio of 1:2. So dekho, this is the dentino enamel junction. Okay, and this is the enamel. Okay, so diameter kya hota hai? Yaha se yaha pe jab jata hai, it increases. It is less here. At DJ, the diameter is less. At DJ, the diameter of enamel rod is less. Okay, but at the surface it becomes two times. So the ratio is 1:2. Okay, okay. So diameter of rod increase from DJ to surface in a ratio of 1:2. So DJ mein 1 or surface mein 2. Okay, so I remembered it like that, DJ 12. Okay, DJ 12. So DJ to surface 12. Okay, so this is also an MCQ. okay, found in your dental pulse. Not only dental pulse, this is exam question actually. Rod dimension, so this is also MCQ, we have to remember, memorize, okay. Width is 5 micrometer and length is 9 micrometer, diameter is 4 micrometer, okay. So this is keyhole, see, this is the structure of the enamel rod, okay. Keyhole in appearance, dekho, keyhole dikhai de raha hai na, what I told. I was poor in drawing, but I can show you with nice pictures. I have good knowledge of graphics. Okay. So, yeah, I'm good in presenting with graphics. So, this is a keyhole. Okay. Keyhole pattern seen in transverse section. Transverse section mein aapko keyhole appearance dikhai dega. Okay. Fine. Then cross section of rods. There are three types. Okay. This rod, enamel rods are of three types. Circular, parallel and keyhole paddle shape pattern. Okay. So, teen tarike ka hota hai, circular, parallel and keyhole pattern. Okay. All three types of pattern are seen in human teeth, but most common is type 3. Most common kya hai? Type 3. Okay. There are three types, but most common is type 3. You have to remember this MCQ. Okay. Next, direction of rod. Okay. So this is very, very important. Please concentrate while I explain this. In the deciduous teeth, direction of rods are different in the deciduous teeth and in the permanent teeth. Deciduous teeth mein or permanent teeth mein आपका जो डायरेक्शन है एनामेल रॉड का वो डिफरेंट है. इट इज डिफरेंट. तो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस इन डेसिडियस टीथ. हॉरिजॉन्टल एंड सर्वाइकल एंड सेंट्रल पार्ट. सो दिस इज द डेसिडियस टीथ. सी द एनामेल रॉड इन द सर्वाइकल पार्ट इट इज हॉरिजॉन्टल. ओके. एंड इन द सेंट्रल पार्ट ऑल्सो हॉरिजॉन्टल. हॉरिजॉन्टल इन द सर्वाइकल पार्ट एंड द सेंट्रल part. Okay. Cervical part and central part, it is horizontal. When approaching the cusp, they are slanting. See, when they are approaching the cusp, they are slanting. Okay. Samajh mein aa raha hai sabko? Understanding?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes.
Okay. Okay. So here, aapka horizontal in the cervical and central third. Okay. But when it comes here, when approaching the cusp, these are kaisa ho jata hai? It is slanting. And at the tip of the cusp, completely vertical. See, at the tip of the cusp, it is completely vertical. So this is an MCQ. Okay. You have to remember. Okay. Then in permanent tooth, you see in permanent tooth, horizontal in occlusal two-third of the crown and apically. So this is to be remembered. See, here it is horizontal in the cervical. Deciduous mein at cervical it is horizontal, but in case of permanent teeth in the cervical it is apically directed or gingivally directed. Apically baki sab same hai, apically directed. Okay, but in the cervical it is apically directed or gingivally directed. Okay, next. So permanent maxillary molar enamel rods, what is the constituent? 12 million rods. This is also an MCQ. Permanent maxillary molar mein kitna hota hai? 12 million rods. Okay. And permanent lower incisor mein lowest 5 million rods. So this is the highest, this is the lowest. That's why we study these two. Okay. Then next, now we will study about gnarled enamel. Gnarled enamel or gnarled enamel, whatever it is, I find it very difficult to pronounce this, but this is very important. Okay, intertwining of rods following a curvy irregular path towards tooth surface. See, it is occurs near the incisal and occlusal area. Occlusal area or incisal area mein there is intervening like this. Okay, you see here, this is intervening, right? So this is known as gnarled enamel. इसको gnarled enamel बोलते हैं. This come as one mark question in for first years and NEET MDS में ये आ चुका है 2017 I think it came. अभी बात करते हैं what are Hunter Schrager bands. Okay, तो Hunter Schrager bands क्या है? Bands मतलब क्या है? Okay, dark. This is Hunter Schrager bands are light and dark band. Okay, यहाँ पे dark band है, यहाँ पे light band है. Light, dark, light, dark, light, dark, light, dark. This is Hunter Schrager bands. Okay, and where do we see? This is important. We see it in longitudinal cross section. Remember, longitudinal, not transverse. Longitudinal. And how do we see in reflected light, not transmitted light? Reflected light. This have to be remembered. ये आपको याद करना है, ठीक है? Light and dark band seen in longitudinal cross section and reflected light. Okay? ठीक है? Routine microscopy transmitted light is used. In routine microscopy we use transmitted light, but to see Hunter Schrager bands we have to use reflected light. Okay, this is an MCQ. Fine. Diazone. Now diazone kya hai, parazone kya hai? Okay, diazone are enamel rods that are sectioned longitudinally. Okay, parazone are sectioned transversely. Diazone are dark and parazone are light. How to remember this? Itna sab kuch maine bol diya. Everything is fine, but how to remember? So you remember Dildar Patel, okay? D L D, okay? So D for diazone, okay? L for longitudinal, and D for dark, okay? P for parazone, T for transverse, and L for light. Okay, so this is the mnemonic Dildar Patel. Okay, Dildar Patel. Patel are generally Gujarati people, and Gujarati people are very rich. So rich hai, so you think that rich people is very Dildar. He never wo kanjusi nahi karta hai. So Dildar Patel. Okay, then angle between diazone and parazone is 40 degree. This is an MCQ. Angle between diazone and parazone is 40 degree. Okay, now this is Hunter Schrager bands. Okay, you can see here like zebra. This is the dark strip, this is the light strip. This is Hunter Schrager band. So you draw this in your exam. Okay, if possible. Now incremental line of stria of Retzius. Okay, this also you have to remember. So incremental line of stria of Retzius kya hai? These are concentric lines like growth rings of tree. You know cambium. Cambium humko pata hai tree mein hota hai jo aise circle circle circle. So similarly this incremental line of Retzius, see these things, this part is known as incremental line of Retzius. Okay, next. So surface structure of enamel, these are the three surface structures of enamel: perichymata, enamel cracks and rod ends. So what is perichymata? Perichymata are transverse wave like groups supposed to be external manifestation. This you remember, this is an MCQ. Okay, this has also come in NEET question. So external manifestation of stria of Retzius is perichymata. Okay, external manifestation of stria of Retzius is perichymata. Okay, बाकी सब इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, खुद पढ़ लेना. नाउ नियोनेटल लाइंस. व्हाट आर नियोनेटल लाइंस? एनामेल ऑफ डेसीडियस टीथ डेवलप पार्टली बिफोर एंड पार्टली आफ्टर बर्थ. तो क्या है, दिस डेसीडियस टीथ दे डेवलप आधा उनका पार्टली बिफोर बर्थ, ओके, एंड पार्टली आफ्टर बर्थ. तो कुछ हिस्सा उसका डेसीडियस टीथ का, कुछ हिस्सा बर्थ के पहले होता है और कुछ हिस्सा बर्थ के बाद, ठीक है. तो नियोनेटल द बाउंड्री बिटवीन दिस टू टाइप ऑफ एनामेल, जो बिफोर बर्थ एंड आफ्टर बर्थ, ओके. तो द बाउंड्री बिटवीन दिस टू टाइप ऑफ एनामेल इन डेसीडियस टीथ इज मार्क विथ एन एक्सेंचुएटेड इंक्रीमेंटल लाइन ऑफ रेजियस एंड दैट इज नोन एज नियोनेटल लाइन. तो व्हाट इज इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट, व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ नियोनेटल लाइन. Neonatal line helps in forensic odontology. What is forensic odontology? Study of the tooth structure after the death of a person. Forensic may use karna. So how it helps? So see, in the interior part of India, there are lots of villages in India where female jo child hota hai usko maar dalte hai after birth. If they see this is a female child, they kill the child, okay. So to know whether the child, they say that this female was born dead, okay, that is called stillbirth, okay. They say un log bolte hai ki ye bachcha to mara hua hi paida hua tha, but through this neonatal line we can identify ki wo bachcha mara hua paida hua tha ki zinda paida hua tha, theek hai. So this is the importance of neonatal line, okay. This is also an MCQ. Then dentino-enamel junction. What is dentino-enamel junction? Dentin or enamel ke beech ek junction hota hai. Okay, so that is dentino-enamel junction. Okay, this is the enamel. Okay, aur yaha pe socho dentin hai. Okay, so this portion. Okay, this portion is the dentino-enamel junction. Okay. So it is scalloped in cusp and incisal edge. Here, cusp and incisal edge, it is scalloped. Scallop means like this, okay? Scalloped ऐसे ऐसे होता है. ठीक है, smooth on lateral surface. Lateral surface में smooth होता है. Convexity towards enamel. So, and I'll show you a picture. And concavity towards dentin. So this I'll talk later. So see, this is scalloped pattern of DJ, okay? Concavity and convexity you can see, okay? Convexity towards enamel and concavity towards dentin. Okay. Now this. Okay, we talked that this dentino-enamel junction convex hota hai, concave hota hai. But in some cases there is flattened, flat hota hai, flat dentino-enamel junction. Where is this flat dentino-enamel junction found? It is found in Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, dentinogenesis imperfecta and scleroderma. Okay, so flat DEJ kaha kaha pe hota hai? Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, dentinogenesis imperfecta and scleroderma. Okay, so ye sab aapne nahi padha hoga first year, please don't mind, you will study this in third year oral pathology. But if you can write this in your exam, the examiner will be highly impressed. बट गड़बड़ तब होगा जब उसने पूछ लिया व्हाट इज Ehlers-Danlos सिंड्रोम. प्लीज टेल मी इन वाइवा, आपके पेपर देख के बोल रहा है व्हाट इज Ehlers-Danlos सिंड्रोम. यू हैव रिटन सो इंटेलिजेंटली Ehlers-Danlos सिंड्रोम. सो इफ यू राइट इन योर पेपर, मेक श्योर दैट यू नो दिस थिंग्स. ओके, व्हाट इज Ehlers-Danlos सिंड्रोम. डेंटिनोजेनेसिस इम्परफेक्टा आपको पता होगा, स्क्लेरोडर्मा यू माइट नॉट बी नोइंग बट यू शुड नो. ओके, इफ यू राइट इन योर पेपर यू शुड नो दैट थिंग. ओके, so while I present this seminar, yeah, presentation karta hu, whatever I don't know I try to I don't try to explain that, not I mean whatever I write here I must know everything. Whatever main padhata hu wo main pehle already prepared hoke aata hu, then I give lecture to you. Otherwise I don't get what I don't know, I don't tell. Okay, so number of features can be seen at the dentino enamel junction. So dentino enamel junction mein teen cheeze humko dikhai de sakta hai, enamel lamella, enamel spindle, enamel tuft. So lamella kya hai? It is leaf like structure. ओके, स्पिंडल हम पढ़ेंगे बाद में। टफ्ट क्या है? ग्रास लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, ग्रास आर लाइक टफ्ट्स, राइट? टफ्ट ऐसे ऐसे होता है ना, ग्रास टफ्ट्स। तो एनामेल टफ्ट्स आर ग्रास लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, स्पिंडल हम पढ़ेंगे स्पिंडल इज लाइक स्पिंडल, एनामेल लमेला इज लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर। तो दिस इज डेंटिनो एनामेल जंक्शन, आई शोड यू, दिस इज द स्कैलॉप पैटर्न। देन एनामेल लमेला इज थिन लीफ लाइक एक्सटेंडिंग फ्रॉम एनामेल टू डेंटिनो इनामेल जंक्शन। तो यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर एनामेल लमेला, एनामेल टू डेंटिनो इनामेल जंक्शन, दिस इज द डायरेक्शन। यू रिमेम्बर दिस टू पॉइंट्स, ओके? दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टू पॉइंट्स, दिस इज एनामेल टू डीजे एंड इट इज लीफ लाइक, ओके? देन थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ एनामेल लमेला आर देयर, टाइप ए, टाइप बी एंड टाइप सी। ए एंड बी आर सीन इन अनइरप्टेड टूथ, ए एंड बी अनइरप्टेड टूथ, एंड सी इज सीन इन इरप्टेड टूथ, ओके? तो टाइप ए दिस इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट। नाउ वील गो टू एनामेल स्पिंडल, ओके? तो नैरो एक्सटेंडिंग 25 माइक्रो मीटर इन एनामेल, ओवर एक्सटेंडेड ओडोंटोप्लास्टिक प्रोसेस दैट हैव क्रॉस द डीजे। एक्चुअली एनामेल स्पिंडल जो होता है, दिस आर रेफ्यूजीज, यू कैन कॉल देम रेफ्यूजीज। दे वे आर नॉट मेंट टू बी प्रेजेंट इन द डीजे, बट दे हैव ओवर एक्सटेंडेड। ओवर एक्सटेंडेड हो गया ओडोंटोप्लास्टिक प्रोसेस। ओडोंटोप्लास्टिक प्रोसेस आर सपोज टू बी प्रेजेंट विद इन द डीजे, ओके? बट दिस एनामेल स्पिंडल, देखो एनामेल स्पिंडल आर समथिंग व्हिच हैव क्रॉस्ड द डीजे। इसमें नाम एनामेल है, पर काम डेंटिन का है, ओडोंटोब्लास्टिक प्रोसेस। प्लीज रिमेम्बर दिस, एनामेल इस मिसनोमर पे मत जाना, डोंट गो विद द मिसनोमर। यू रिमेम्बर दैट दिस इज ओडोंटोब्लास्टिक प्रोसेस। हाँ, इन एग्जाम दे विल आस्क यू कि एनामेल स्पिंडल कहाँ से वो होता है, इज इट फ्रॉम अमेलोब्लास्ट? नो, अमेलोब्लास्ट एनामेल, एनामेल स्पिंडल ओडोंटोब्लास्ट, ओके? तो एनामेल स्पिंडल आर ओडोंटोब्लास्टिक प्रोसेस, ओडोंटोब्लास्टिक प्रोसेस, ओके? नेक्स्ट एनामेल टफ्ट, आई टोल्ड यू दिस आर रिसेम्बलिंग टफ्ट ऑफ ग्रास। सो सी दिस इज लाइक टफ्ट ऑफ ग्रास, ओके? दिस आर एनामेल टफ्ट, ओके? नाउ सीमेंटो एनामेल जंक्शन के बारे में पढ़ते हैं। तो देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सीमेंटो एनामेल जंक्शन। सीमेंटो एनामेल जंक्शन थ्री टाइप्स होता है। सीमेंटम ओवरलैपिंग, दिस इज एमसीक्यू 60%। देखो दिस इज द सीमेंटम, ओके? दिस इज द सीमेंटम एंड दिस इज द एनामेल। सीमेंटम इज ओवरलैपिंग द एनामेल, ओके? तो दिस इज 60% ऑफ द केसेस इन इन ह्यूमन बीइंग्स वी फाइंड सीमेंटम ओवरलैपिंग द एनामेल, ओके? देन बट जॉइंट मतलब सीमेंटम और एनामेल एक ही जगह पे मिलते हैं, दे कोइंसाइड, ओके? दिस इज द सीमेंटम एंड दिस इज द एनामेल, दे मीट एट द सेम प्लेस, ओके? सो दिस इज नोन एज बट जॉइंट। एंड फेलिंग टू मीट, ओके? दिस इज सीमेंटम एंड दिस इज एनामेल, दे डोंट मीट, ओके? सो दिस इज 5 to 10%, ओके? दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर, दिस इज एमसीक्यू, नीट एमडीएस एमसीक्यू, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ओके? नाउ सम ऑफ द एज चेंजेस, बूढ़ा होने से क्या होता है? व्हाट आर द एज चेंजेस इन एनामेल? एनामेल इज ए नॉन वाइटल टिश्यू, वी टॉक नॉन वाइटल टिश्यू इनकेपेबल ऑफ रीजेनरेशन। मेस्टिकेटरी रिएक्शन के कारण ये डिजेनरेट हो जाता है, ठीक है? देयर इज एट्रिशन, एब्रेशन, एफ्रेक्शन, दिस थिंग्स यू विल स्टडी इन योर थर्ड ईयर, ओके? दिस आर द डिजेनरेटिव, रीजेनरेटिव और डिजेनरेटिव चेंजेस, ओके? ओल्डर पेशेंट वेयर फेसेट बोलते हैं उसको, व्हेन द डेंटिन, जो एनामेल इतना होना चाहिए था, अभी इतना है सिर्फ, तो इसको क्या बोलते हैं? वेयर फेसेट, वेयर हो गया इसका, ठीक है? एंड एनामेल एंड डेंटिन इरोड्स, ओके? इरोड इरोड हो जाता है। डिस्कलरेशन, टीथ डार्कन विथ एज, ओके? डिपेंडिंग ऑफ डेंटल कलर, ये खुद से समझ लेना। परमियबिलिटी, तो यो आई टोल्ड यू दैट एनामेल इज सेमी परमिएबल, Okay, so young enamel behaves as semi-permeable membrane, permitting passage of water and substances through pores. With age, the pores diminish as crystal acquire more ions and increase in size. So, क्या होता है? The permeability decreases with age. Okay, normally the enamel are semi-permeable in nature. Okay. So these are the differences between deciduous and permanent enamel. So deciduous is lighter in color, bluish white. Permanent is darker in color, grayish or yellow white. Thinner, this is thicker. Rods are perpendicular to DJ. This is directed gingivally. This I told MCQ. Apne direction of enamel rods I told. In this is horizontal hota hai. Isme apically or cervically directed. More supplemental grooves are there in case of deciduous. Here less supplemental grooves are seen. Okay, so this was all about our class for today.